Hello and welcome back to my channel. This is Aadi. Well, I have a very unique story for you. As I'm sure a lot of us enthusiasts and geeks of the Indian Air Force would have wondered one time or the other, when was it that the Indian Air Force caught its first air-to-air victory? This is a story about two braveheart brothers fighting the battles in the air in the 1965 war called the Keelor brothers, or as I'd like to call them, who fought the battle against the Pakistanis, flying the same aircraft and winning Veer Chakras, each one of them. So stay tuned and find out how this story goes. Of course, before that, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do and press the bell icon so that you come to know when I put the next video. Here is the story. This was the time of 1965 when the Pakistanis launched the Operation Gibraltar. The Operation Gibraltar was launched by the Pakistanis with a view of creating an unrest within the state of Jammu and Kashmir. What they had done was infiltration, as they do it all the time. They had infiltrated close to about 40,000 soldiers behind the Indian lines with a view of creating an unrest with the local population in Kashmir. Well, I think reality had skipped their minds that even in the war in 1948 as well as 65, as well as in 1999 during the Kargil war, it was the locals who came up to the Indian armed forces and informed about the Pakistani misadventures within the Indian territories. They failed in their entire inquest, and as they so far as to claim that they won the war in 1965, it is a big fat lie. This is now the story of the Sqn Ldr Trevor Joseph Keelor. He was born on the December 8, 1934 in Lucknow. He studied in St. Francis High School in Lucknow and of course did his college in Missouri in La Martin Air College. He joined the Indian Air Force in 1953. Well, on the September 3rd, Keelor, along with other pilots, were woken up at about 3 o'clock in the morning for a MET briefing, as the Air Force, who had just suffered some bad losses in the Vampires on the 1st of September, the Air Force had to hit back and they had planned a retaliatory raid. These pilots were a part of it. They belonged to the number 23 Squadron, Indian Air Force, based in Pathankot at that particular point of time. The Indian Air Force planned a trap. At about 700 hours, four Mysteers took off from Pathankot, flying on course to Chum. They were flying at a low level of about 1500 feet, literally showing themselves up to the Pakistani radars, trying to lure the Pakistani sabers onto a battle. The Pakistanis took the bait and launched six sabers to come and intercept the Mysteers who were flying towards the Chum sector. Six sabers were also accompanied by two Starfighters, which were the latest ones in the Pakistani inventory at that particular point of time and were pretty much no match to what the Indian Air Force had to throw at them. Come what may, the Indian Air Force went across with this attack. What the Pakistani radar did not see was two flights of Finger 4 formation set NATs who were approaching the target at about 300 feet. They were doing this to avoid radar detection, as it is very difficult for the radar to see below an altitude of 500 feet because of ground clutter. What had happened was the Air Force had planned to lure in the Pakistanis, showcasing the slow and older Mysteers whilst keeping the NATs at bay and pouncing at them with the NATs to take revenge of the Vampires they had lost on the 1st of September. The NATs were being flown by Sqn Ldr William Johnny Green, who was the flight leader, flying with Flying Officer M.R. Murdeshwar as his wingman. Sqn Ldr B.S. Sikand and Flight Lieutenant V.S. Pathania were also in the second group. Following this lead section, another Finger 4 was led by Flight Lieutenant Trevor Keelor at a height of about 100 feet. He was flying with Flight Lieutenant Krishna Swami as his wingman, and the second pair was flown by Sqn Ldr Amarjeet Singh and Flying Officer P.S. Gill. The minute the Mysteers came to know about the approaching sabers, they turned hard as planned into the mountains. Once the Mysteers were gone, the NATs were in their space to do what they had planned to do. The first set of sabers were visually spotted by Trevor, who spotted one coming at about 5,000 feet trying to latch onto Sqn Ldr Green's section. That was the time the NATs did something that they had planned to do, a defensive break, each man for himself, finding his own target and taking the damn sabers down. Keelor, who had found one of the sabers going behind the flight leader's formation, got behind the saber and went into a turning fight. After a lot of tugging and pulling, Keelor found himself at a great attacking position of about 450 yards, and then he opened his power to come down to about 200 yards and opened up his 30mm cannon on that saber, and the bullets hit the wing of the saber, literally disintegrating the saber and it going into a spiral dive right into the ground. That was the moment the Indian Air Force had scored its first air-to-air victory against the Pakistanis. As a matter of fact, this was the first time the NATS guns were used in anger by anyone, and it was successful. This in spite of the fact that the Sabres had air-to-air missiles, which makes this feat even more remarkable. A funny incident occurred during this time. Sqn Ldr Sikand's NAT, who was low on fuel, who got disoriented because of the whole battle scene, saw an unoccupied runway and thought it was an Indian base. He landed on that base to realize it was a Pakistani Air Force base of Pasroor. He was captured and kept as a POW. His NAT IE-1083 is on display at the Pakistani Air Force Museum in Karachi even to this day. Just to digress from the story just a little bit, the anti-aircraft regiment of the Indian Army killed its first saber on the 4th of September when Hawaldar C. Pothraj of the 127 Air Defense Regiment was manning a 40mm Bofors L-30AA gun at the Tawi Bridge near the town of Jammu when a saber flew over it and he took him down. For shooting down the F-86, both Keelor and Pathania, who shot down another F-86 on the 4th, were awarded the Veer Chakra. Green, for leading this entire troop into combat, was awarded a Veer Chakra as well as Hawaldar Pothraj, who got a Veer Chakra for his actions with his anti-aircraft gun. Flight Lieutenant Keelor, on the 5th of February 1964, found himself flying a NAT from Pune to Palam. He was at about 41,000 feet when, as per the flight plan, he had to descend down to about 15,000 before making the approach. Upon reaching 15,000, he realized there was no response from his engine and some of his flight controls. Knowing the fact that the NAT was not really prepared for a dead stick landing and knowing the risks involved that he had to take, he decided to take those risks and with his skill brought the NAT down for a successful landing without any damage to himself or the aircraft. For this action, he was awarded the Vayu Sena Medal. Now let's talk about the next brother. He was known as Squadron Leader Denzil Keelor, who was a Veer Chakra winner. He got his Veer Chakra on the 19th of September 1965, born on the 7th of December 1933, and of course studied again as his brother in the La Martinière College in Missouri. Joined the Indian Air Force 1 year later on 6th of November 1954. Let's talk about his Veer Chakra story. On the afternoon of the September 19th, 1965, a flight of four Mistias were detailed to carry out an offensive attack in the Filora sector of the Chavinda area. In this case, the Mistias, as usual, which was made as a rule by the Indian Air Force, having a lot of confidence with the NATs, were given top cover and escort by this aircraft. Number 9, the Wolfpack Squadrons did not really at till that time participate fully in the war. This was their chance. The 9th Squadron NATs were flown on that day by Sqn Ldr Denzil Keelor flying off to Rai, and the second pair by Flight Lieutenant Kapila as the subsection leader with Flight Lieutenant Vijay Mayadev as his wingman. It was a unique distinction which was going to unfold on this day. The NATs, which were following the Mistias at a low level as was done before, were greeted by anti-aircraft fire. This anti-aircraft fire was going above the NATs as the NATs were flying at a very, very low level. At this same time, the number 4 in the formation, Mayadev, gave a radio call to all the other NATs about spotting sabers, 4 sabers actually approaching their location. The NATs were about at 300 feet and the sabers were approaching at about 4000 feet. At this time, Keelor put the entire team on a shallow climbing turn to be in a very advantageous position right behind the NATs at the 6 o'clock to be able to put in the immense damage that they had planned to do. The Sabres tried their best to shake them off, but did not happen. The first Sabre was put to task by Flight Lieutenant Kapila, who saw a Sabre right in front of him. At a range of about 500 yards, he opened fire, scoring hits on the Sabre. He closed in, opening his path to about 300 yards and fired again. During this time, Kapila suddenly realized that he was at a very low level and he pulled off, did not see the aircraft go down in flames. His teammates told an excited Kapila over the radio that he had shot down his first Sabre. Looking at Kapila shooting down one of his teammates, a Sabre came behind Mayadev and Kapila's formation, targeting Mayadev, who was his wingman, right behind the lead formation aircraft and successfully scoring hits on Mayadev's aircraft. Unfortunately, the aircraft was non-responsive and Mayadev had to eject very low level on off the ground. He came down, drifting down with his parachute, and was captured by the Pakistani forces, making him a POW for the rest of the war. Keelor, who was flying around looking at this very carefully, noticed one of the Sabres coming out of the fight and trying to rush home pretty fast. Keelor put his aircraft right behind him. The Sabre, realizing that there was someone behind his six, went on to a turning fight. This took them very close to the ground. By this time, Keelor was sure shot and put some hits on this particular aircraft, scoring the first near kill. By this time, Kapila, who had joined this particular formation, came around, saw this Sabre trailing smoke, and put an end to his misery, and the Sabre went crashing down onto the ground. Both the pilots, Sqn Ldr Keelor as well as Flight Lieutenant Kapila, were awarded Veer Chakra for their brave and gallant efforts. It was like both the brothers had to win two medals each. Group captain by that time, on the 27th of March 1978, doing a training session on a MiG-21U, had a structural failure when his canopy flew clean off the aircraft. He realized he was in danger. He suffered from sudden decompression at an altitude, apart from the environment hitting him straight on his face. He got a control of this aircraft and landed back to his base safely. Later, the same year, on the 17th of May 1978, during firing trials of the 23mm cannons of a MiG, he had a shell exploded, causing extensive damage to his aircraft, making his second dangerous landing safely back onto his base. For this effort, he was awarded the Kirti Chakra.
Trevor Keelor
retired from the Indian Air Force at a rank of a wing commander in the year of 1978. Trevor Joseph Keelor passed away on the 27th of April 2002.
Denzel Keelor,
who went up to become an Air Marshal in the Indian Air Force, was also awarded by citations of Ati Vishish Seva Medal and the Vishish Seva Medal, along with his Kirti Chakra and the Veer Chakra. And he is now the chairman of the Special Olympics Bharat. I hope I've answered the question for those aviation enthusiasts who are looking for the two brother heroes who fought the battles in the air against the Pakistanis in the war of 1965. One of them bringing the distinction to the Indian Air Force by achieving its first air-to-air kill. There are many more such stories like that none of us have heard of. I am here to make videos and bring them out for everyone to learn and get inspired from the soldiers who fought and fought hard for this country. Like I say in all my videos, share a thought for our soldiers starting in the battle lines today, in the land, the sea and the air, once a day, every day. Jai Hind!